Hi there, Doug Stimmer with IT Creations. Today I have the 2U12-based Supermicro Hyper A Plus 2025HS-TNR rack server. With that A Plus in the name, you know it was the teacher's pet. Well, actually that means it has an AMD EPYC processor, two of them to be exact. This one is compatible with both the 9004 series and 9005 series processors, but it does require a software update to support the 9005 series. If you like our channel, hit that subscribe button. Shall we? As part of Supermicro's Hyper Systems, the Supermicro Hyper A Plus 2025HS-TNR is also one of Supermicro's flagship servers, boasting energy efficiency, performance, and flexibility for the data center. This system is designed for cloud computing, virtualization, AI inference, and machine learning, and you know what that means. But before we go there, software-defined storage and use as an enterprise server. That last is a pretty broad category. And yes, this system can be configured with a few GPUs to support the all-important AI inference and machine learning capabilities. On the front of the system, there are 12 3.5-inch hot swap storage bays for NVMe, SAS, and SATA storage options. You can have 12 SAS, 12 SATA, or 12 NVMe drives, or a combination, depending on your needs. With all of those options, you will need additional cables and definitely a controller if you go with SAS. To the left, a small control panel with a power on button at the top, combo unit ID reset button, and then a few LEDs for power, HDDs, NIC1, NIC2, power fail, and information, which is kind of a general operational status indicator. Are you interested in the Supermicro Hyper A Plus 2025 HS-TNR server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure using our handy configurator that's valued at $5,000 or more. If that sounds like a deal to you, then when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video, itcreations.com. On the back of the system are dual redundant power supplies, in this case, 1600 watts each. Then a dedicated management port outlined in green, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, a VGA port, and an advanced I/O module that is OCP 3.0 compatible to support a number of optional network connections and ports. If you don't want to use any of those PCI slots, that AIOM connector is a good thing. PCI slots above, and there are several options for those. For management of the system, Supermicro has a few software suites up its proverbial sleeve. SuperDoctor 5 or SD5 can be used in a command line interface or through a nice graphical web-based interface, both for Windows and Linux operating systems. SD5 has two versions, one for local management and one for remote management of the system. For remote management, you will need the out-of-band management package, or OOB. It can also be used with Nagios, which is an open-source program that provides more tools for monitoring and managing the health of the network. With SD5 management server, you get even more tools and can remotely power on the system. The Intelligent Platform Management Interface, or IPMI, can also provide remote access monitoring and management. Remote management is accessed through the integrated ASPEED AST2600 module on the system board via the dedicated RJ45 management port on the back of the system. There are a few more features like SuperCloud Composer and the Supermicro Update Manager, but let's move on. Inside the system, starting at the back, you can see the PCI slots and the BI16 connector for the advanced I/O module. All PCI slots are PCI 5.0. The system can be configured with up to 8 PCI 5.0 by 8 slots, 4 PCI 5.0 by 16 slots, or you can mix and match to get a combination that will complement your workload. With support for the AMD EPYC 9004 and 9005 series CPUs, this system is also CXL 2.0 compatible. Now, a little bit more about those PCI slots. Supermicro has definitely provided options here, and I'm going to say the basic is either 4 by 16 slots or 8 by 8 slots, and then combos in between, like such. There are no integrated LAN ports, as you will be using either the OCP 3.0 compatible AIOM connector or one of those PCI slots for network communications. Also to support an optional RAID controller or host bus adapter if you want a bit more control over your storage with options for data protection. In addition, there are two PCI 3.0 by 4 slots on the system board for NVMe M.2 drives. Those can be used to support your OS and a mirror RAID for redundancy and resiliency. As I said, GPUs are supported. You can install either two double-wide GPUs or two single-wide GPUs. There are quite a few that have been validated by Supermicro, including the NVIDIA H100 80GB and the H100 NVMe with 94GB, both with Hopper architecture. Those two are your basic go-to for AI workloads, but there's also the L40 and the L40S, plus several Ada Lovelace and Ampere options for not only AI, but other workloads. With the NVIDIA H100 and the H100 NVL, I was wondering what the difference is. Turns out the H100 NVL has higher bandwidth HBM3 memory as opposed to the HBM2 memory on the standard H100 GPU. Also more memory at 94 gigabytes compared to a top end of 80 gigabytes on the non-NVL model. With that, the H100 NVL is also more useful for large language models. It's also optimized for data centers with lower power consumption compared to the H100. Two NVIDIA H100 NVLs can also be linked together using three NVLink connectors on top for up to 188 gigabytes of memory when combined. Each H100 NVL also supports up to 7 12 gigabyte MIGs or multi-instance GPUs. This system supports dual AMD EPYC 9005 series CPUs with a thermal design power rating of up to 400 watts. That does limit the supported processors to 160 cores and 320 virtual threads each for up to 320 physical cores and 640 virtual threads with both sockets outfitted with 9845 CPUs featuring a TDP of 390 watts. Next one above, which is not supported, is the AMD EPYC 9965 with up to 192 physical cores and 384 virtual threads and a TDP of 500 watts. SKUs for the 905 series CPUs start at 16 cores and a TDP of only 125 watts, so there are a number of choices here. If you go with the AMD EPYC 9004 series processors, you can still get up to 128 physical cores and 256 virtual threads. That would be with the 9754 EPYC processor, which has a TDP of 360 watts. If you need to address specific applications that could benefit from more cache at the CPU, then there is the 9004 series CPUs with 3D V-Cache, and those top out at 400 watts with the 96-core 9684X and 1,152 megabytes of L3 cache. There are two more with an L3 cache of up to 768 megabytes compared to standard AMD EPYC CPUs with L3 cache ranging from 64 megabytes to 384 megabytes. With 24 DDR5 memory slots and dual processors, each with 12-channel memory architecture, either 9004 or 9005 series will support one DIMM per channel for optimal performance and top memory speeds. For 9005 series, memory speeds of up to 6,000 megatransfers per second are supported, while the 9004 series will provide up to 4,800 megatransfers per second. With two DIMMs per channel, that speed could be reduced, but that is not the case here. For optimal performance, there would be one DIMM in each memory channel for better memory bandwidth, like we have here. That's not to say you can't install less than 12 DIMMs per channel, because you can. Also up to 128 PCI 5.0 lanes. That would be for a single socket system. With dual processors installed, it knocks it down to 160 PCI 5.0 lanes. Still very respectable. As part of the Hyper server line, the Supermicro Hyper A Plus 2025HS-TNR server can be used to support a number of high-performance computing workloads. With dual GPUs installed, it can be used for AI inference and machine learning applications, not to mention virtualized environments and some high-end VDI with multi-instance GPU aspect. I do hope you enjoyed this short overview of the system. I posted a few links in the description below, or you can use that link right there. Looking for something else? Check out itcreations.com. If you have any questions on this system or another, post them in the comments section below. Till next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.